We're a pretty laid-back family, but we'd like to be laid back in a tidy space instead of laid back in hell.
I think the worst room is the kitchen. There's dirty patches and just makes my skin crawl. It's really disgusting.
And then there's the beetles.
All of the beetles are there.
I kind of need a new order so that when my mum and dad come round, they don't perch on the edge of the seat in case they catch something.
This time, the nation's dream cleaning team, Kim Woodburn and Aggie McKenzie, are driving to Deptford in deepest, dirty London.
What are you doing, Kim?
Aggie, you can see the dirt on the window. Can't be doing with it.
You never stop, woman.
You want to see you, don't you?
Kim and Aggie's tireless tirade against tardiness is never-ending. Today's targets are the Rance family, mother Jackie, 12-year-old Annie and 5-year-old Daniel, who takes after his free-spirited mum, while long-suffering sister Annie seeks solace in the only tidy space in the house, her bedroom.
Bit by bit, this mess started to build up. Didn't really notice it at first, until it reached a certain level.
There's bugs on the floor. There's lots of bugs on the floor.
The situation is clearly out of control. Time for Kim and Aggie to inspect the rancid rance abode.
Isn't it?
Come in through the valley. Come on, get in there.
Ooh!
Let's have a look in this kitchen. Oh, it's a horror show. Oh
my God, what a pong.
Chaos, isn't it?
Look at all this filth and stink.
You are not going to believe this.
The chef's pinafore.
Disgusting.
Own for business, dear.
That's just grand.
Kim. Look, we've got beetle. I think that's a textile beetle.
Yuck.
What is that?
I don't know what that is, actually. I know what it looks like.
God help me, sorry. It's not poo-poos. It's beef stock.
Good news.
Kim and Aggie will be getting in a stew next door, too. The living room is alive.
Let's have a look and see what's under the sofa, shall we? Look at this. Gaz, thick.
I bet you find a few bugs in there when you look close, Aggie.
Look at this!
Aggie, what is that?
Looks like larvae of a carpet beetle.
This one's living, though. He's well living, isn't he?
Oh, that's
Aggie's
horrible.
Dreadful. You've got your work cut out, haven't you?
Under the watchful eyes of the creepy Crawlies, Kim and Aggie enter Mummy's tomb of terror.
What? Oh! She's living in absolute squalor.
It's very unloved, isn't it?
Unloved! Yeah. It's hated!
Stinky poos.
Look, it's absolutely putrid.
I hate to think how much is in here, Kim.
Yeah, I'll watch, Aggie. Stand back.
Oh, yeah.
Woo-hoo! Woo-hoo! And on that cheerful note, get out.
Choked to death.
The depth of dust in Mother Jackie's room is more than matched by the debris in little Daniel's den.
Oh, my goodness me.
What is this room?
Have you got your climbing books, Kim?
Well, is this his little boy's bedroom?
I think it was.
Where does the little soul sleep? And everything, you know for a fact.
I know. It's such a shame.
I've got to get out. Hang on, Aggie. Excuse my bum, Ag.
I normally do.
Let's go, Agsy. Let's get out. We'll get it lovely for him. That's a promise, isn't it, Aggie?
Oh, this must be the little girl's room.
You can see the floor.
Oh, well, there is hope.
She's making an effort, though, isn't
she?
Oh, come on, Agsy. Great.
Time to confront the filth offenders.
Oh, here they come.
Bold as brass.
In.
And you in.
You won't be smiling for
long. I don't know what you've got to laugh about. I'm disgusted.
You know,
I'm frightened to touch the walls in this flame kitchen. Oh, look. Isn't this the picture of hygiene and health, isn't
it? That's my granddad's apron.
Rancid.
Mommy wears
it. What, when you're preparing food? No.
No, of course
not. Washing up and gardening.
Well, you don't wear it off and then do you, dear? I'll tell you why. Washing up and... Please. How far is the place you put this garbage?
At the end of the corridor.
About a few metres of a walk. No wonder you've got bugs in this house. They're having
they're
a ball.
They're never on there. They're only on the floor. We don't let them...
We don't let them climb.
How do you know they're not travelling between the surfaces and the floors?
How do you know?
Because we look.
Because we check.
Yeah. Oh, yes, because you're so fastidious, aren't you?
I mean, it's just, it's appalling in here.
It's an absolute... It's a slum. It's a slum. I'm sorry to use those... It's a slum. What have you let it get in this mess for?
I lost interest and it just... I didn't want to start nagging the kids and I didn't want to start laying down the law. And we're kind of... I don't know, we're easygoing, but I think we're a bit too easygoing.
Annie, you seem quite keen on keeping the place clean.
It just kind of makes my skin crawl.
So, actually, we've just got to get weaving here, haven't we?
There's a lot of work to be done.
Right. Get going. Come on, family. Got a lot of work to do.
It's time to give this place a lift. So it's off with the civvies and into the whites. Followed by an elevator full of extra cleaning might. The cordons unrolled around the filthy Rance household. Let the cleaning commence! The flat is in the grip of a growing tick. Now, there's only one thing for it. Where's the skip?
Come on, get rid of it. I can't clean till you've got it all out. You hurry up as well. You've got...
Come on, then, you lot. Get moving. Haven't got all day. Thank you very much, Annie. Come on.
Kim, really? Get him to get a bend on, will you?
Temper.
5-year-old Daniel says he's been making a record-breaking attempt.
My bedroom is the messiest bedroom in England.